Here we are unboxing and going to install our kitchen printer, which is an Epson TMU220B, and we like to use a network interface as opposed to serial or parallel USB for our kitchen printers, which means this will be installed or plugged right into the firewall. Little roll to get you by a knife. Ribbon. Power. Kitchen printer. Got a few pieces of tape. Let me take off two pieces. Three pieces, four pieces, very easy to open, use a switch. This is where the paper loads in. This is where the ribbon will load, so we'll do the paper first. This is not thermal paper. This is regular 3-inch paper, 3-inch wide. Drop that guy in. Put in our ribbon. I like to give it a little tight turn, make it all nice and tight, right as I put it in. Alright, gives you a little instructions, 1, 2, 3, on how to install this guy. Put my right end in first, push down with the left. It's in, give it a little turn, just make sure you are good. Close it up. And it's in. Now we connect the wires. Always go into a power protected source, which I'm going to use our backup battery here, which also has smart power protection. What we got here? It's a NIC card, Cat5 cable, plugs right into it. And here's power. The only two cables you need to plug into these kitchen printers. Power it up. Get a network patch cable. In this particular example, we've got one point of sale terminal and one kitchen printer. So we've got point of sale terminal going into LAN port number one. And it really does not matter which LAN port you plug into as long as they're in there. It will just go chronological. So I'm going to use number two, the next one. Going in the firewall is standard Cat5e. The B standard terminated ends. And we're gonna go right into the printer. Okay. Power on the printer. Power switch right here. Little power light. Little activity. Now what I do wanna show you guys is a little reset switch down here. It looks like a reset switch. It's on the NIC card. If you hold this down, for about 3 seconds. This will print out a little configuration page. So this printout just helps show you what the current IP address is of this printer. So the top line says it's 192.168.192.168, which is the default address of a brand new Epson network kitchen printer. So now we go into the computer. So let's just verify that we can remote into the printer's configuration page by IP address, just to make sure we have connection. This is the network. This is the Epson configuration page. If we go into TCP IP, we can see what its IP address is as well. So if you have multiple kitchen printers, you would need to statically assign each one of the kitchen printers with a different IP address. And this is where you do it at first. So we're not gonna change it now. We're just observing what the IP address is and making sure that we could remote into it. That's all we need to do here. So let's close out this page. All right, so we're gonna create a new printer now in Windows. All right, now to do this is gonna be a local printer attached to this computer. I know it's not really, but this is what we gotta do in Windows. So follow each step. We're gonna create a new port. We're gonna create a TCP IP port. All right, here's where we put in the IP address, 192.168.192.168. Finish. We use generic text drivers. Manufacturer's generic, and the printers, we're just using generic text only. We don't need any specific printers right now. Specific drivers right now. We're going to rename this in a second. Since this is a network printer, we're just going to call it Net Printer Kitchen. Don't need to make it, doesn't matter if it's default or not. In Windows, we'll just say no. We do want to share it out. That's okay. Don't need to fill that out. Yes, let's print a test page. And once I hit finish, we'll get our test page. So now it prints inside of Windows. Congratulations. When you see congratulations, that's good. All right. Yes, it printed. Thank you very much. So now we've got two shared out Windows printers. We like to get in the habit of naming what printer is with the connection type. So our kitchen printer is we call it Net Printer for network printer, and we just label it kitchen. We've got a USB printer attached here. It's a thermal printer, USB thermal. It goes a long way when you do troubleshooting, tech support. Now we got to tell 2Touch about our Windows printer here. Options admin, we want to go into system settings now. We want to go into printers. We either create or rename our printer that we have here. So out of our liquor starter build, we've already got one set up in here. We're gonna go into our 2Touch Zero Kitchen. Open this guy up. It's the name of our printer, 2Touch Zero Kitchen. Your network name, let's find it. And we're using our Net Printer Kitchen here. The emulation, we'll use the Epson TMU220 with the cutter. It's great. I put one blank line on kitchen prints. See if we can get a test sprint. Looks great. All right. Yes, it printed correctly. And that's installing an Epson U220 network kitchen printer.